pitching to get picked up on these editorial playlists on Spotify, Apple Music, Tidal, it's a complete waste of time. So the most popular one that people always go and try to get on editorial playlists on, that's Spotify. They're known for the playlists, right? If it wasn't for the playlists, they probably wouldn't be a thing. Not just because of the scam playlists, which they're well known for, but also for the fact that people like to create their own playlists. But every platform has a playlist option. So that doesn't really make Spotify special. What makes Spotify special is that people think that, man, if I can get on one of these big editorial playlists, then I'll be set, I'll be good, my music will go. And I've talked about this many times. I understand the premise of trying to hop on a big playlist. You're going to be getting in front of thousands, if not millions of people possibly, right? But when it comes to Spotify, their record is dog shit now because it's been exposed so much that even the editorial approved playlists from Spotify are filled with bots, right? Like everybody knows, like the smaller playlists, everybody knows the smaller playlists are filled with bots. However, these big ones are filled just as much, you know, and we've seen it across the board from when Chad Focus got busted a few years back all the way until, you know, Meg Thee Stallion just getting 30 million, you know, streams pulled off of her account here in 2024. The thing is that, like I said in the last video, Spotify is no longer the place to do your promotion, right? And like I said, I get the premise. Hey, you get opportunity in front of a ton of people. However, the best way to get an opportunity in front of a lot of people is to run a paid advertisement. Paid advertising is the way to go. All right. Apologize. Swatting in my face and stuff. Mosquitoes are getting crazy right now. It's almost essentially August here in the Midwest, and I'm out here in the woods, as always. Got bug spray on, but still doesn't work the best. Anyway, the best way to actually reach millions of real people, The best way to reach millions of actual real people are through paid advertising. To run strategic ads at the exact group that you know or think will fuck with your music the hardest. Not the group that you wish fucked with your music the hardest, but the group that actually does fuck with your music the hardest. And see, there's many different ways that you can kind of try to get that. And I've discussed it many other times as well too. You know, from knowing at least 10 artists or bands, whatever your situation is, that you're the most similar to. That's a great way to advertise to that audience and see if you resonate with them. If you don't resonate, well, now you know that you picked the wrong audience. But when it comes to these editorial playlists, like I said, they're bullshit. And I get it. You're like, man, I just want to get heard by millions of people. Well, you can. You will. Through strategic advertising. You will get in front of thousands, tens of thousands, hundreds of thousands, millions of people. Depends on how long you do it and how correctly you do it. You will be able to get seen in front of millions of people if you do it month over month. And you're going to be getting added to those people's individual playlists, which is in turn going to activate the algorithm on all these streaming platforms and say, oh, so these people who also listen to these people, like this one? Okay. So everybody else who also likes these other artists, they're probably gonna like this person too. So let's put it in front of them and see. Well, they put it in front of them. If they like it, then the algorithm knows, hey, I got in front of the right people. Hey, y'all saw that one too, huh? Then the algorithm knows, hey, I got this person in front of the right person, right? But actually, now that I think about it, it doesn't really work like that, actually. The algorithm doesn't care if your music is put in front of the right people. The algorithm cares if it puts the right music in front of its listeners. Because see, Spotify, Apple Music, Tidal, YouTube, they don't care about you. They don't care about you, the artist. They don't care about how good your music is. They don't care about none of that. All they care about is customer satisfaction, customer retention. That's it. And the one way that they get that is by feeding the people exactly what they like. And they learn that. The more somebody is on their app, the more they will thumbs up, thumbs down, do a general search, add people to their playlist, do a save, stuff like that. All these different actions will get people, will get the algorithm, all these different actions will get the algorithm activated for that individual and get the content that they would most likely enjoy put in front of them. And so through strategic ads on Meta platforms, Google platforms, whatever, you can actually put your stuff up in front of these people at a pretty low rate, honestly, and get in front of them, give them a taste of what you got, and see if they fuck with it. Like I've said many different times, getting on one playlist with a million listeners is nowhere near as powerful as getting on a million listeners' individual playlists. You know how fucking powerful that is in the algorithm? See, a lot of people have it backwards. They think, I just need that one shot. No. You need millions of shots. You need millions of at-bats. And that's what social media can bring you if you know how to use it right, if you create the proper kind of content. See, video is the currency of the day. Okay? TikTok really, really brought that to full surface. And so, as you know, Gary Vee and other people like to call it, the TikTokification of social media has changed how social media activates and how social media works. See, it's no longer about, oh, if somebody is following somebody, we need to show them that person's content. No, it's not a follower-based algorithm anymore. It's an interest-based algorithm. Just because somebody loves you doesn't mean they love everything that you do. And these algorithms and social media companies have realized that, right? They've realized, hey, look, they may be following these people, but they don't always activate the different triggers to tell us that they like every piece of content. However, if we put in front of them a bunch of different people's content that is all similar to the same vibe that they like, well, look at that. They start liking, they start watching more everything. So whenever I tell artists, hey, look, stop doing graphics, okay? Yeah, you need a graphic for the streaming platforms to put your music up through DSP. But don't spend a lot of time and money and effort and energy and all that shit on it, because it won't get you the return that you want. Don't spend time on motion graphics. That is a half-assed attempt at creating video content when in reality, you're an entertainer. You're in the entertainment business. So go and entertain, okay? That's just what it comes down to. If you're in the entertainment business, you need to entertain. And if you are not wanting to do all that, you're in the wrong business. Go sell cars. Go work at a grocery store. Go do literally anything else. If you're not willing to hop on camera as often as Harkus does, if not more, then you're not in the entertainment business. You don't belong here. Get the fuck out of here. And it's very, very simple. You can do it in very simple ways. I've talked about it many times on here, and I'm not saying this as a pitch, but here's a little pitch that just kind of came out of nowhere. My course called TikTok Style Music Videos, it's absolutely free, okay? Go check it out, apexmusicsystem.com, free course, 100%. No tricks, no scams, no none of that shit. It's a little over an hour worth of video content that shows you exactly what I'm talking about. And I even give you examples. It's very simple. You use your phone, even if you don't check out my course, right? Even if you don't subscribe to shit, you don't check out my course, none of that shit, right? Listen, here's the principle behind it. Use your phone and create entertaining and engaging music videos for free on your phone. You're already using your phone. You're already paying for it. So why buy a camera? Okay? If you want to, go for it. But I've seen so many different artists, so many different times, get caught up on the, oh, I need the proper equipment trap. And then they can never, ever get the right equipment. It's always, oh, well, I need this now. Oh, well, I need that now. Right? And they get caught in that trap. When in reality, you have your phone. If you have an iPhone, you also have iMovie. Edit it in there. You can use CapCut. That's completely free. If you want to edit it on a computer, CapCut has a desktop version, or you can also get a free program called DaVinci Resolve. Edit your shit. Oh, well, Harcos, I'm not a video editor. Guess what? CapCut is created to where 10-year-olds can create video content, okay? So unless you are not smarter than a 10-year-old, you can do it. Trust me, it's not that fucking hard. And like I said, I even go over in my course simple ways on how you can use CapCut. It's free. They got like a, you know, pro edition as well too that gives you some extra effects, but it's very simple. You don't even have to use a lot of effects. See, a lot of people, they get caught up on this whole thing where, oh, well, you know, I gotta have industry quality video. You're not on industry level. I'm sorry. And what they mean by that is mainstream industry level. You're not on that fucking level. You only got hundreds, maybe thousands of listeners. You don't need to worry about that. Because not only do people see through all that shit, and they're like, yo, this dude only has a fucking 1,000 monthly listeners. There's no way that stack of money he's got in his video is real. There's no way this is that. There's no way that's his fucking Bugatti. Shit like that, right? People can see through it. They know it's fake. And they don't like it. But on top of that, you're wasting your money. You go and spend $1,000 on a music video one time. How much are you going to spend on advertising? Zero. How much are you going to spend on, you're trying to do a PR run where you're getting in blogs or getting on podcasts or radio shows? How much money are you going to spend on that? Zero. Oh, because it does cost money. All right. Sometimes you can get on, like, you know, startup podcasts and blogs and stuff like that for free or damn near free. But you want to get some decent exposure on radio or podcast or even the internet through ads, you got to spend some money. Okay? And let's say you're just being modest and you're dropping one song a month. Well, if you create a music video for that song every single month, that's $1,000 a month. That's $12,000 a year that you're spending on just music videos only. Okay? Unless you make $112,000 a year, and you live in a really poor area, or you got, you know, spouse or family or whatever, you can't be affording that. So that's why I say, create music videos for free with your phone, or hell, if you live near a college, go to the AV area and start seeing, you know, high school and college, maybe not high school, right? Because, you know, underage shit, right? But you go to college, right? Go to the AV area and see if anybody wants to intern. You know, maybe say, hey, look, I don't have a lot of money, but, you know, you need some experience. You need a portfolio. Let's work together. You know, I'll shoot you $50, $100 every video, something like that. I just can't afford, you know, $1,000 a video, right? And you work out a partnership with some college student who's trying to get their portfolio built before they graduate. And you start getting some shit, right? Either way, do it yourself. You use the resources you got. Maybe you got, like, you know, a son or a daughter or a nephew or a cousin or something like that who's trying to get in the video editing game, maybe a homeboy, homegirl, girlfriend, whatever the fuck, you know what I'm saying? Use, like Adam Ivey always says, use what you have until what you have pays for what you want. But you create that content for as free as possible. And then, bro, imagine how much reach you can get for $1,000 a month in ads. Are you fucking kidding me? I spent $430 one month, about a month and a half, 2 months ago, right? In June. And I got 100,000 eyeballs on my piece of content. So you could get at least that. Because if you got more popular sounding music than what I did, right? The shit I put out was boom bap, conscious, pretty run of the mill stuff, nothing fancy. And I had great conversion. I'm still getting thousands of streams a month and haven't spent a single dime since, because I had real people who liked my shit that I put in front of, and they like it. They added it to their playlist, they're listening to it at the gym, listening to it when they're out and about, everything. And they didn't just add that song, they added many other songs from my catalog. And see, all these things that I'm talking about to you right here, that I'm also always talking about, you know, here in these videos or on Music Making Sense podcast every single week with KP or Capone or whoever guest we have on, we're always talking about the same shit. Think smarter and work harder. Okay? I know a lot of people are like, well, no, that's not how it goes. It's work smarter, not harder. No. Because a lot of people think that they're working smart in order to be lazy. So that's why I say, think smarter, work harder. Work harder in the right areas. You gotta think smart, you gotta think before you act. Right? And I think that is really what the motto should be. Maybe I'll even call this video that. Think smarter, work harder. That's a good one. Anyway, sitting here getting in my own sauce right now. But if you take, like I said, if you make pop music, you make trap music, you make that shit that is the sound right now, which I don't, that 400 and some dollars can get you way more than 100,000 eyeballs and get you way more than just thousands of streams a month. You could be getting tens of thousands of streams a month, multiple hundreds of thousands of eyeballs, more followers, more followers, more listeners, more fans going over to your website, hopping on your email list, hopping on, you know, buying your music, buying your merchandise, supporting you. But you got to get in front of people, and spending $1,000 on one music video, or fuck, even $500 on one music video, that's a waste of $500 when you can spend that towards ads. And those ads will get you, but you got to know how to do them right. See, that's the caveat. You can't just throw out an ad. You can't just hit boost. You got to know what you're doing. You got to know who to target. And there's plenty of resources online to figure this out, free and paid. I didn't go to fucking college to learn the shit that I know. But I know one thing. I know how to run a targeted ad. I know a decent amount about marketing, sales, advertising. And I didn't learn it from college. All right, I learned it from teaching myself, having a want to learn it, and doing it. And so y'all can do it too if you want to. If not, as I always say, hit me up. I can help you out, no problem. All right? But you have to create content. If you don't have content on a regular basis, I can't even help you. Gary Vee couldn't even help you. Whoever you look up to is like, oh man, that motherfucker's the GOAT. What's that guy's name? I can't remember his name now. But anyway, no matter who it is, the biggest advertising person, Dr. Dre, fucking Jay-Z, nobody could fucking help you. Beyonce couldn't help you. If you don't create content on a regular basis that is entertaining, engaging, then nobody can help you. None. And that's the bottom line, because Harco said so. So create content. And then get to work smarter and harder.